Hello, this is Falterfire. Because I am dangerously irresponsible, even though I have places to be relatively soon, I'm gonna record another run. So, I asked the Discord which deck I should play, and they said I should play, or one day specifically, said I should play Ally Sacrifice Midrange on somebody. And he initially suggested Drophis, but I don't think you get enough value out of Drophis to justify it. So instead I'm going to go Paladin. So, let's go with, Rogue AI. That sounds like a good name for it. We are going to kill everyone. Why don't I just rename that? I'm paying attention. Can you tell that I am super awake right now? Oh, it's because there's no new deck. I need to get rid of. That one can go. Let's go with. All right. And so. The idea here is that we are going to abuse Paladin's, I don't know why we're getting, I guess the idea here is that we're going to get value out of the extra shield. Unfortunately, there's not like a man card that summons a runic sprite, which would be really cool, but there is no card like that in the live patch. So we need to figure out something else to do. Now, Field Barrier doesn't actually give us tough, so I do kind of want to do that. Pocket Sand is pretty good. I don't need other mana cards to absorb demise, because it's not nerfed yet. And probably just Resolute Focus. So that's a full set. Could go just like this. Gonna have some problems getting damage out, but hopefully not too many. So, in the pool. This is changing in beta, but it's not changed yet. We just add those, because why not? Fighting Fusion is interesting, because it does give us a lot of sprites, but... I don't think we're going to have mana boost. But we might have... we will have wit. I don't want most of the Spirit Summon cards, but I do want that one. Let's get that. Let's get... Mana Eruption, I guess? Chaotic Barrier is also very tempting. I should have considered Arcane Silence. Because I do like having that AoE Arcane. Kind of getting there just by putting in cards that seem reasonable without actually thinking about it, which is fun. Automated Shield, we don't usually want to sacrifice, but we can. And it's one of the better allies just have sitting around. We are low on mana, especially by my standards. And I have no clue how we're going to win. But all our cards are vaguely on theme, so, you know, that's got to be worth something. Don't really have an art that that says this is a rogue AI. That, That conveys the spirit of what we're doing, at least. Get it? Get it, the spirit? He's got, like, a ghost. Sure. I don't really want to deal with white flame. Shoot, white flame will kill our friendos. Let's do that. So we want to go here. I don't think it matters as much here. Emerald Dragon tends to be more obnoxious, but Paladin can shock things to get value out of the other thing. I know, I'm very eloquent. We already bought stuff there. Let's go Plains. Partially just because I often don't. Tend to default to Valley just because I don't even know. Interim growth gain seems good. Alright, we do get this. Ideally, we would like a reroll token by the time we get there, so I think we're going to go through there to try and get a reroll token. Because if we can get Extract Potential, that card is incredible. I realize that by doing it that way, we don't get to redraw the Absorb Demise, but... I wanted to get the Pocket Sand value. Maybe wish I had Pocket Shield as well, but too late now. Naturally, the card we draw is the one that we least wanted to draw. Maybe just end there. Bleed is super obnoxious. Really a point in playing anything, just loses more health for not much gain. Alright, one more friend to kill. Going ahead and healing back. Big fan of this one. Big fan of that one, though. That's Cleanse and Tough, which we don't have either of right now. This is the potential downside. You can get these really bad hands. It's pretty unlikely. We do have four summons and only three. Like, that was two of our three whatever cards and zero of our four, whatchamacallits. Zero of our four summons. But it can happen. As far as I'm going to go on that, should check closer on which runes we're dealing with. We get shocked here. I'm not really sure why they... Oh, it's because I'm shocked. Like, I don't know why the damage on these guys is so high. The answer is because I'm a big dummy. rude. At least we aren't bleeding this turn. I'm gonna do both of these, but getting the shield out is actually more important. Although I guess we didn't actually get the shield because I'm an idiot, but it's fine. Right. We're going to at least be able to cleanse off one of the bleed, which is good because I do not like having this much bleed. Unfortunately, we only get to cleanse off one of the blade. I'm going to build up the extra wits here. Look, we'll eventually get a kill. I promise. Things proving way slower than I was expecting, though. I'll tell you that much. And you have these frenzy turns coming up with no barriers. It's annoying. Fuck you. Unfortunately, even through the shock, we don't take too much damage here. We only have one problem left. I imagine I had a way to transform these stones, though. Hopefully, we should be able to finish out this fight this turn. Okay. Can I pass up a Void Hardened skin? I don't think so. I don't think I'm capable of it. Rip. was a very unfortunate turn one. Again. I don't want to give us any things like, you know, it's unlikely that we will get hands like that, because then we get hands like that back to back. Oh, whoops. Messed up. Hold that for now. Fortunately, our mana is largely taken care of, so. Oh, I messed up. Putting the draft card in our deck. It isn't even supposed to be in this version. So that's going to do actually less damage to our friendos than it's going to do to us, because we have shock. Interesting. Oh, right, it's a bug on this version that the overheal effect doesn't pass on. Storm is good, so we're ready to stack powerful. We're going to pass this up so we can force extract potential. This fight can be annoying, because it's another fight where Blade can just get spammed at us, but... Oh. We at least get shielded if we don't get the other stuff. Guaranteed to draw into a focus. However, I think that's worth it. And our summon should be able to live through this. Not a huge fan of the bleed. Decent chance of mana. That guarantees mana. And let's kill you. Because this one's going to set up evasion this turn. And now I should be able to charge blade this one to death, I think. Just kidding. Because, there we go. Now we can charge blade to death, or we could sand it to death. So we can get some healing. Big fan of this, I think. This is the kind of thing we just need the mana, though. Okay. Really? 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 Fuck you! And our summons are about to get got. And not much we can do about it. Fortunately, this guy doesn't come in with lifesteal. I could have prevented that summon, and I probably should have, but I wasn't thinking, because I should have done that sooner. Probably we're going to try to not do too much this turn because bleed. Strictly necessary. The upgrade absorb device first because it's a lot better when it's 2 mana. This deck should speed up once we find some payoffs, but for now we don't have really have space for payoffs, so. Now my summons are all going to die. Oh, actually only one of them. I'll take it. But we aren't bleeding. They're becoming increasingly powerful. So now the fun starts, where we start getting just smashed by the big guy. It doesn't look like much of this because we have Fortress right now. This one does have lifesteal, but fortunately we're able to get to, thanks to Field Barrier, we have a decent amount of damage reduction. Field Barrier and other stuff. Although once the leak wears off, yeah, it gets worse. I should say, once the leak wears off and the, whatchamacallit? Hey, got it. That means we can now get extract potential. Didn't even need the reroll token. That's not bad. This is a card draw trinket though, so never gonna pass it up. Never gonna give it up, never gonna let it down, etc. I upgraded that first. We do need to upgrade Absorb Demise, but the extra powerful stacking should be good. Sure, that's my excuse. I definitely meant to do that. Let's do that. That's pretty okay. They give us some arcane. We're absolutely going to get artillery here because it should be great. You can die. Step one is just getting that dead, and then we'll work on killing. Whatever. Because if we can free up another summon slot, obviously it makes our lives easier. Feels a little silly to do that, but we're about to shuffle, so I might as well get it in the draw pile. Okay. And this guy is a jerk. Very happy that we get to do that though. If we do that, we get frozen, we don't get the summon. Actually, we don't get frozen because it's dead. That's an AoE thing, so. Alright. A very reasonable amount of damage from pockets and damage. bad news, bucko. I got way too much powerful. We're now one pocket sand away from victory, I think. And that assisted strike should also kill. Yep. Get dunked on. Really liking this not having to reroll thing. All the cards in the deck do work. Take the frenzy buff. Make sure that the texts I've been receiving related to the thing I'm going to very shortly are not a problem. They are not a problem. Blocking a summon may actually cause problems. Just because it means that this guy's going to get lots of value. We do get this frenzy turn, which is nice. I just can unblock the summon. That'll have to do for now. I'll just have to hope that it can't actually punish us for our hubris before we get the skill out. Alright, we have one more turn to try and... Actually, we have two more turns, because even though it has Berserk, if it dies, it loses its powerful, which will reduce... which will get rid of most of the threat. Sacrifice that one. Now this does mean that there will be room for a summon that we'll have to kill next turn, but it's not going to be a problem. Get sanded. Mana eruption is pretty good. Dissect is pretty good. Take the dissect, upgrade the absorb demise. No, absorb demise, there we go. Remove, I don't know, nothing. Keep rolling. Never admit mistakes. We just take events as much as we can, anyway. Bet. Triple Drake could be annoying, but we have pocket sand. It counts as triple direct answer, right? Oh, whoops, I didn't fly fast enough. I had to make sure that one died. All of this is strictly necessary. Wait for ally turn to pass. I know that we're stacking. Oh, right, but that works. Yeah, that seems good. Potentially. See if we can clear this guy out. Which means that now. And there's space for that summon. Even if we don't get as much value out of it as I would like. And they're even being nice enough to not try and set up that one thing. Oh, I should have sacrificed the other things. Well, it's fine. Actually, delay even doesn't even matter which one I sacrificed. Probably not. Sure, that seems fine. Starting tough is okay. Double cleanse also is potentially useful. I think glittering reflection is the thing I want most, but I'll take silica card. Upgrades. I kind of want to get Ring Sprite Pluses because we get extra wits from them. The other option is that we just like upgrade mana. Oh man, that upgrades the action 3 times. Or we can get extra cannon blasts. Just all the cannon blasts. Fire all of the guns at once and explode into space. In a manner not dissimilar to a legitimate child of nature. You become more powerful than they can possibly imagine. And guild. Did I tell you things were going to speed up? Because things do speed up. Probably just got the explosive end. I'm not the hugest fan of it. Because there are a lot of times where I don't actually want to use it. Because it just doesn't do that much damage. It does not freeze. I guess we don't actually care that much about dripping the opportunist attack here. Oh, I didn't realize it was an AoE attack. That's actually pretty obnoxious. I'm sure it'll be fine. What possible downsides could there be to getting double shocked? We are about to lose 5 fortresses. This is gonna go damage is gonna go pretty up pretty far. I gotta do this for the mana. We have to do that. Draw some absorb demise. And then. Alright. And there was a little awkward, but it didn't matter. This turn is potentially going to hurt, especially with that blade. Can't play that anyway. Shocked, but That'll do. No health lost. Fight over. I really want this Devourer's Strike. Tier of Trash. That's very good. That Mangano and Alley Death is incredible. We're going to go ahead and cut the Explosive End. It's fine, but eh. Not a huge fan. We're going to upgrade. These upgrade to, like, yeah, 4 Fortress this turn, which is very good. Yeah, we're just going to go Event. It's not going to do much for us, but yeah, I guess it's worth discarding. Sure. And then I'm just going to copy the mana, actually. Unfortunately, I get to block whatever. Plan is to cannon next turn for value. Manageable, I think. Yeah, we don't get the full set of cannons, but good enough. Setting up additional evasion is rude, but I'll just leave you up so you can get extra whatever hits, and we don't actually really need that. Maybe we could have actually devoured it, but decent chance to get the whatever this turn. Yeah, there it is. I realize I'm being incredibly eloquent when I say things like the whatever this turn, but look, I know what I mean. Probably. I kind of expect the guy to not survive that. And I think we just let this sit. Mostly because I want to get all these things to happen. Especially like the turbo growth. Who knew? cannon. Another cleanse wouldn't go amiss. And let's see if we can deal with this guy. Decent chance we spend a decent bit of this fight shocked, and I just have to hope that's fine. Do that. Alright, we get mana back whenever allies die. I have to remember that. Surprise people showed up 2 hours early. Surprise people showed up 2 hours early, so I am going to have to finish this quickly. Plan is, it doesn't matter if we get shocked, because we can tank it. It's fine. Oops. Can eat the health loss here. I'll be fine. I might do this, I think. There goes the shock barrier, so we're good on that front. Just get the mana out. Oh, always missing that. Here we hit that may or may not kill everything. I think you have to copy that. Made space in hand. Kind of. Summons. So I need to die faster. I'm glad we have this. There we go. So spiritual would be nice, would be useful if we needed to actually, if we wanted to actually keep Alice alive, but I don't think we do. I don't think we actually want dragon form. I think it's a little too, yeah. I do like mystical bloom though. Extra shield gain is good. And then get the extra power stacking there, because we can. It's really easy to cut cards, and I gotta go. So that's gonna be it for this time. Depending on how long part two is, I may just staple to the end of this video or maybe a separate video. In case I don't end up stapling together, until next time, toodles.